name. Ladder Pathway. Once upon a time, there lived a king who ruled a happy and a prosperous kingdom. The people of kingdom were very happy and lived a life with abundance of wealth and misfortune. One day the king decided to travel and visit various places in his kingdom. He visited various historical and pilgrim centers in his kingdom. He went to distant and remote places where his chariot couldn't reach, so the king visited many of those sites on foot. Traversing long distance on foot was a wonderful experience for the king. He got to interact with his people and learnt about their life and problems. Many people were very happy to meet the king and expressed how they were very happy under his rule. But the king wasn't used to long walks. He got a severe pain on his leg. He could not tolerate the pain as he walked all the way through the rough path. He complained to his ministers that the roads weren't comfortable and were very stony. The king also expressed his concerns for the people who had to walk along those roads every day. For the convenience of the people, the king ordered to cover all the roads in his kingdom with leather. The king believed that this will make his people's life more convenient. The ministers were stunned to hear the absurd order from the king. Not only was the king's fantasy of having the leather pathway expensive, it would destroy life of many cattle to get sufficient leather. A wise king's advisor came to the king and said that he had a better idea. He took the size of the king's feet and made a nice comfortable leather shoes. He made the king wear those shoes and walk on the rough paths. The king admired the comfortable leather shoes as he did not feel any pain walking on it. The king applauded the genius idea that saved money and thousands of cattle lives. Moral of the story is, many of us criticize the world for many things. The desire to change the world all sounds very heroic and noble and grand. We blame that the things around us for the struggles in our life and never remember to look inside ourselves. Changes are inevitable in the world and the changes should be from us. Remember, it's not the world that needs to change, it's ourselves. Story name: The Falcon and the Branch. Once a king received two magnificent peregrine falcons as a gift from one of his vassal state. They were the most beautiful birds he has ever seen. Though the falcons were still quite young at the time, they were beautiful specimens groomed for keeping in his court specifically. The king called the head falconer and handed the two beautiful birds to be trained. The falconer trained the birds for months. But one day the falconer informed the king that one of the falcons was flying and soaring high in the sky, while the other has not moved from its branch since the day it had arrived. "I have never come across a bird as stubborn as this before," the trainer complained to the king. He went on to describe how the creature ignored, refused, and stubbornly lashed out at his every attempt. "Maybe there is something wrong with this bird. It just won't fly," said the trainer. The falconer was one of the best in the land, his talents widely lauded by all who knew him. So, the king decided to give the trainer some more time to make the bird fly. Months passed, but the falcon never moved from the branch. The king summoned all healers, sorcerers, and other trainers from all the land to make the falcon fly. But none of them succeeded, and the bird did not move from its perch. One day a farmer was passing by the palace and heard about the stubborn falcon who wouldn't fly. He thought he would give a try to make the bird fly. Having tried everything else, the king was desperate to make the bird fly, so he allowed the farmer attempt to make the bird fly. The next morning, while the king was thrilled to see the two magnificent birds soaring high in the sky from his balcony, the king did not witness the feat himself. So he had the farmer brought before him to answer to his questions. "I would like to know your secret," the king said. "Tell me, how did you achieve what the most highly trained, intuitive, and wise men could not? How did you make the falcon fly?" The farmer peered up from beneath his brow. "It was actually quite simple, your highness. I just cut the branch on which the bird was perched. We all are made to fly. But at times we sit on to our branches, clinging to the things familiar to us and never attempting for a change. The possibilities in the world are endless, but most of it remains undiscovered because we never attempt to go beyond our comfort zone. We conform to the familiar, the comfortable, and the mundane. We need to go outside of our comfort zone, destroy the branch of fear we cling to, and free ourselves to the glory of flight. We will come with some other interesting short stories in our next videos. Till then, take care and be happy.